Greetings, humans. Greetings, and welcome back to another fun-filled episode. Bear here, 29-year veteran of the woods, and the first bear in space. Ah, but today, in another first, he'll be reviewing the comic book called, Impossible Stars, from your boy Zach and Chuck Dixon. So join Bear on this amazing space adventure into the stars. Bear's comic picks. Yes, indeed. Ah, but when Bear was launched into orbit, he was sucked into a mysterious black hole. Luckily, on the other side, Bear was relieved to see his home planet still there. So Bear plunged his spacecraft into the atmosphere, happy to return to Earth. But when Bear opened the hatch, he was surrounded by primates. Damn you! Damn you, dirty humans! So Bear escaped into the woods, living like a primitive animal ever since that fateful day. So when Bear was out foraging through the neighborhood trash cans, the postman came up, delivering a package to little Timmy McTimerson. Well, Bear swiped left and then right, and the postman ran away, dropping this package. As the first bear in space, Bear thought he would review it for you good humans. So let's get started. Space. A really cold place. Our story begins as the starship Hyperion races faster and faster. The puny humans inside, Arid Cruz and Barry Driver, are trying to become the first Earthlings to reach faster than light speed. But something goes horribly wrong. The mission is forced to abort. Back on Earth, Mission Control watches in horror as two of their bravest pilots plunge into the atmosphere of a dwarf planet. Wait, no, our story begins 2 years later. A beautiful young woman stands bedside an immobilized patient, leans over, and gives the masked individual a sensual kiss. Okay, alright, our story begins 5 years later. The starship Savitar is set to take the mantle of the first to FDL. But once again, tragedy strikes. Not only in space, but here on Earth as well. A mysterious bolt of energy from the heavens ends the lives of scores of humans along the eastern seaboard, leaving not only physical scars, but emotional ones as well. Then a voice from beyond the stars. All humans are quarantined to the solar system. Never attempt another FTL jump, or else. But one brave human doesn't agree. Captain Tyrus Sheldon Blake, denied a chance at greatness. Blake doesn't believe the alien menace is real. So Blake gambles the lives of his crew to chart a path to the stars and become the first to reach FTL. The only thing that stands in the Shinobi's way is the defense fleet on Alderaan Station. As Blake and his crew escape, they destroy the space station, attracting the attention of General Kobayashi and Fleet HQ. Earth is concerned that Blake's jump to FTL could endanger the entire human race. So he sends the only man that he can trust, Aaron Cruz. Lone survivor of the fatal Hyperion crash, Cruz must lead his ragtag group of explorers and capture the Shinatobe before Blake can reach the edge of the solar system and initiate his jump to FDL. The two play cat and mouse, dodging asteroid belts and planetary rings on their way to ultimate destruction or everlasting greatness. With everything on the line, Blake and Cruz battle it out the only way Bear knows how, to the death. And a shocking twist ending that will change everything for the human race. That's right, so if you do not want to be spoiled by this ending, then skip ahead to this mark. That's okay. Beer will wait for you. All right, that's enough waiting. Beer continues. Major Aaron Cruz isn't the lone survivor we thought he was. Barry Driver, also aboard the Hyperion crash that day, had his DNA fused with Aaron Cruz to form the mighty Driver Cruz. Dun, dun, dun. The hybrid Driver Cruz have their own mission in mind, to be the first to reach FTL and mark their place in history. But their actions might mean the end of history and the entire human race. While this twist surprised Bear, it didn't have as much foreshadowing as he would have liked. A bit of setup in the beginning might have allowed the reader to connect with Driver and Cruz. As it stands, the ending falls a bit flat because we haven't gotten to know the characters or what drives them. Ah, but we will talk about that in our main review. Oh, which is right now. The main story which Bear gravitated to was the dynamic between Cruz and Blake, a rogue captain seeking glory and a by-the-numbers military hero who has a mysterious past. Throw in an alien presence, a ticking clock, and you have a great story. However, what we have here is too much story and not enough page count. Both Blake and Cruz need a little bit more meat on the bone. Blake begins the story with his daughter. She is recovering from the attack in a hospital bed. Blake believes that he must prove himself to her, a promise left unresolved. His crew, however, is less defined. Why they go along with Blake's murderous motivations isn't clear. Bear thought that some internal conflict would add to the tension, but the one storyline that hinted at any misgivings ended too quickly. Early on, Blake dispatches one of his crewmates, and while shocking, it could have used a little bit more buildup before that final act. Also shrouded in mystery is Major Cruz. While a compelling character, with a crew thrown together on an impossible mission, the end scene needed a little bit more setup to pay off the final conclusion. The early pages hinted at this, but didn't have enough space to properly introduce the characters, enough to make an impact, so to speak. And the alien presence provided the grand stakes in the story, but it was really only a framing device for what was otherwise a solid space adventure. The artwork here from Renzo Rodriguez is top-notch. From the epic nature of the various planets to the tight quarters on the spacecraft and the various characters, Renzo has done some fine work. I would also like to note that the colors from Michael G. Look amazing in this book as well. One of the great things about your boy Zach, Richard C. Meyer, is his ability to marshal disparate groups of folks, like Chuck Dixon, fantastic writer, and up-and-coming talent like Renzo Rodriguez and Michael G. Your boy Zach provides the gravitas and the glue to make a project like this successful. Just that ability alone, getting comics into customers' hands. Well, maybe not little Timmy McTimerson's hands, but you know what Bear means. That ability to get it into the backer's hands is an accomplishment that Bear tips his space helmet to. Criticisms aside, Impossible Stars is very much Bear approved. Yes, indeed, and would recommend and would also hope that this comic isn't a one-off. Bear would like to see more out of the Impossible Stars universe. Hopefully, they're already working on a sequel. Alright, well, all these space adventures has made Bear hungry, so he's headed back into the woods to forage for some more food. Hopefully some space salmon. So until next time, humans.
Humans, thank you for watching this video. If you wish to have more, please like and subscribe. And don't forget that bell for notification. It would please Bear very much. You don't want to see Bear bad, do you?